temporary pain for long-term pleasure. What is that supposed to mean exactly? Well, let's just break this down. Will Doge hit $1? Well, right now it seems kind of far off, right? However, in the near, maybe even distant future, we can see a $1 Doge. And I'm gonna break down everything you need to know, and most importantly, how Doge will get to a dollar. And again, we can go through charts all day long, but at the end of the day, there's a lot more than just charting and technical analysis that come into play. So let's dive into it. Before I start, there's a new content schedule that I have for this month. Every Tuesday and Thursday at 1 p.m. Eastern time, I'm releasing a video. Typically, I release a video every day or so. However, I am going and having a surgery this particular month, and I need to balance and create these videos ahead of time. So if you don't mind, also subscribe to this channel if you enjoy these videos, and smash the like button as well if you want more videos like this. So let's just dive right into it. Now, the first thing I'm gonna say is do not buy the hype. When everybody is talking about Doge, you need to be very wary. So we've seen the fear and greed index when it comes down to Bitcoin, right? We need to go ahead and gauge that as well with Doge. So when people are talking about it constantly, you're gonna have to go ahead and just kind of hold back from getting in at that time. However, when the hype dies down and everything is quiet, very smooth seas is when you wanna start sniping your position inside of Doge. Like right now is a perfect time to start dollar cost averaging your way into Doge, because first off, we're going through a dip in the market, but not only that, we're also going ahead and seeing all the altcoins correct and go, you know, kind of taking a pretty big hit, and Doge being one of them as well. So I actually went ahead and I want to show you the side-by-side comparison between the trends and the Doge chart. This is going to blow you away. Check this out. There's gonna be two things that we're using, TradingView, and again, if you don't know what TradingView is, it's essentially a, you know, a website, an app that lets you see all the charts, all the statistical data for pretty much any pair, whether it's a stock, crypto, etc. So again, you can go take a look. I have no affiliation with them. So first things first, I'm on the weekly, okay? Rather than the daily, the 4 hours, I'm on the weekly because what I went and did was I want to see a direct correlation between trends and between price. So if we take a look at Doge, I went to trends.google.com and I searched Doge in the United States in the past 12 months. Take a look at this. You see how it's literally just flat over here? Well, what can we see on the chart? It's literally flat. It's the same exact thing if we're going side-by-side comparison. We can see it's flat and then it just goes ahead and has this movement upwards in January. So let's see around these upward movements. Look at that, January, and you could see it down here. So you see where my mouse is right here? You see January, February. So let's take a look at January and February. So January, all right, then we have February, and then the hype dies down again around the end of February till the beginning of April. Let's see. So this right here, this is towards the end of February, right? And then we have March, it's stagnant again. So again, look at this, it's stagnant. Right, so it's consolidating. So it consolidated, and out of nowhere, in April, we see the mid-April, I'd say. So April 4th to the 10th, and then we see April 11th to the 17th. So 11th to the 17th, what do we have here? This is April 12th exact. Look at this movement. And if we just take a look at the trends, Doge is at a 94, and then it goes ahead and literally dips. So does it dip? Yes. Look, this dip in consolidation. So we have this dip and then we have another rise back up, another push back up. And what happens? So we have this dip, right? Consolidation, rise back up. Again, right here, dip, then it consolidates around this particular time frame, and then we push back up. So you see that from May 2nd to the 8th, it's at 100. It's even more hype than it was before. Look at the date that corresponds. It's May 3rd. 2021 right here. And again, like I said, you can see it down here where my mouse is, the date, if I hover over this, May 3rd is when that week started. And if we take a look right over here, we can see May 2nd to the 8th, literally times exactly.
with the actual trend, and it keeps on going. And then we, you know, we keep it again. Look at this. I can't make this any more clear to you. The trends is your friend here. We see a dip coming down. It's gonna consolidate more than likely. And then we're gonna see more movement to the upside if it holds true to the previous trend, to the previous cycle that it followed. So again, it keeps hitting higher highs. So, you know, right over here, especially on the trend chart, not even on the regular trading view chart, we can see it's at an 85, then we hit a 94, then we're at 100. So it just keeps getting higher and higher. Well, it can't get higher than 100 on Google Trends, but you get the idea, is that we have seen the all-time high for interest in the United States in the past 12 months between this point. And now we're consolidating again. It's dipping again, and we're going to consolidate, which means that we're going to flatline more than likely, and then we're going to push back up. So what I'm trying to convey to you is that this chart matches exactly to the trend down to a T. So if you ever want to go ahead and take a look at where the trend is, if people are talking about it, if people are hyping it up, take a look at trends.google.com, and I'll even do it with you, trends.google.com. All you have to do is just type in Doge right over here, click search, make sure you're in the US past 12 months, and just take a look at the chart. And if you really want to go ahead and you want to get down to the nitty gritty over the last 3 months, you can do past 90 days, and then you can see what's happening. And if you were to do that, you want to take a look at the daily chart even, and you can go ahead and see the corresponding daily chart. And if we were to go ahead and let's just say April 16th, 2021, it has 100 on the interest. So let's take a look at April 16th, what happens. So April 16th, look at that, on the money, on the money. This is crazy. This is literally crazy. April 16th, on the money, you just have this massive green candle. Doge is talked about everywhere. And let's take a look right over here. Let's take a look at May 3rd till May 6th. So let's take a look at May 3rd. So if I have to guess, we're around here. So May, we're starting to push up. So May 4th, so May 3rd. And we have May 9th over here. So May 9th, let's see what happened May 9th. So May 9th, it looks like it went ahead and started consolidating. So people are like, oh my goodness, you know, Doge this, Doge that. But again, there's interest here. And that's a really good sign. It's a really, really good sign. But I don't suggest looking at it in 90-day terms. I suggest looking at it, zooming out, going to weekly, because it matches up perfectly with exactly what I just said and what I just showed you. So again, take a look at Google Trends. It's your friend, especially if you're if you're trying to gauge how many people are talking about this and how popular it is right now. Use it in your benefit, because it'll tell you the grand story, the overall narrative of what's happening with Doge.
Now, that's absolutely insane how we can use Google Trends to see the chart and how it's pretty much a one-to-one. However, there's something that I also need to discuss. Inside of CoinGecko, you can see if you scroll down under the chart, the trading pairs. Now, why is this important? Is because of the simple fact that Doge is readily available to new investors. So what exactly does that mean? Well, it's easy for any new investor to go ahead and get their hands on Doge, which means more exposure. Let's not forget, there's only about 100 million people that are involved in the crypto space in totality right now. And there's over 7 billion people on Earth. So we have to consider situations such as Elon launching his satellite, which will give internet to everybody in the world, which means that with an internet connection, the crypto space will also grow. We're in the infancy of the crypto space. And again, Doge is one of the leaders in the crypto space with an astronomical market cap. If we just take a look right here, it's at $38 billion, and it's the sixth ranked token in the world. Now, that is incredible, and that just means that a lot of retail investors and a lot of other investors are looking at Doge as not so much a means of long-term value holding like gold or Bitcoin, but they're looking at it as a way to go ahead and be able to perhaps turn a few thousand, maybe a few hundred thousand into, you know, whatever X, Y, and Z amount of money. And, you know, a lot of people that invest into Doge, and I'm going to be very transparent with you as well, and you probably know this as well, is that you're not going to be holding for 10 years or 20 years. Maybe some of you will, and see where it goes. However, a lot of investors are willing to hold for a year, 2 years. And again, it's basically you're going to watch your money grow over time as there's more expansion in the world with the internet growing as well. And like I said, there's only 100 million people on Earth right now that are using and actively involved in the crypto space, which leaves room for so much more growth. We are at the infancy stages. And again, Doge is going to be retaining and absorbing a lot of the money, the retail money coming in, because like I said, it's so easy to go ahead and get your hands on Doge. You can also take a look. Let's just see if we start scrolling down. We can see some exchanges like crypto.com, which has over 10 million users. Gate.io, which I think is the third or fifth one of them. It's a top 10 exchange. And again, it opens so many doors for new investors and retail investors to come in and buy Doge. A lot of time, it's their first investment and their first step in the door inside of crypto, which means that more money is gonna flow into Doge over time. Next, let's not forget about one massive factor, Elon Musk and his support. Here's one thing that I will say. We have celebrities like Elon, Mark Cuban, and others that actively talk about crypto and are very open about, you know, the projects that they look into. Now, I'm not saying Elon's good or bad for the crypto space. In my opinion, he does a lot of good. There is a lot of manipulation that happens as well, and you can agree with me on that, is the fact that he does a lot of good because he introduced a lot of individuals to the crypto space, probably millions of people who wouldn't have been involved in the crypto space and now are. Now, why is this important? Because that money that they invest, if they make more money, they start learning about other altcoins and they take their profits and start investing into other alts and start moving their money around. And that's how we get basically a siphon, a big funnel, where they start off, you know, at the top, which is Doge, and then it gets funneled in their profits, maybe even extra money that they make gets flowed into other altcoins in the crypto space, growing the crypto space in general. Now, we have very bullish sentiments from an individual like Elon Musk saying, if you'd like to help Doge, develop Doge, please submit ideas on GitHub. And then he links to Reddit and then he tags Doge devs. Now, this is really important because of the simple fact that Elon has made it very clear, and Mark Cuban actually pioneered this. He didn't pioneer it, but he pioneered it for his particular brand, which is the Mavericks. In totality, you know, they accepted Bitcoin and I think Ethereum, but I know for a fact they accepted Bitcoin for their merchandise, for tickets, etc., for the Mavericks. And the moment they went ahead and accepted Dogecoin, they were able to make more money in a single day than they ever did accepting Bitcoin. Now, why? Is because Dogecoin is definitely a crypto that can be used by everybody for it to be an actual currency in comparison, because everybody wants to hold Bitcoin, which is in turn a store of value. So you can't compare them side by side. When people have a comparison between Doge and something like Bitcoin or something like Ethereum, Doge is phenomenal to be used as a transactional currency. And like Elon said, it would be very ironic for a meme to take over the currency space and go ahead and become our number one or highly most used transactional currency, which I also think would be pretty ironic. So with that said, support from individuals like Elon and Mark are going to make the space even bigger. Now, here's something insane. We all know that Elon had a lot of backlash when he posted about Tesla removing the fact that they're going to be accepting Bitcoin on May 12th right over here. And we saw the massive correction that happened, and a lot of people go ahead and blame Elon for what's happening right now. However, this correction was supposed to come regardless, and he just kind of sped things up, if you will. Again, I don't blame him whatsoever. He had to make a decision, and there's board members that need to go ahead and make decisions as well. So we can't sit here and blame the man, because he's done more good than more harm in the crypto space in totality. So when people go ahead and blame celebrities like, you shouldn't be talking about crypto, you know nothing about it. Well, at the end of the day, technically nobody knows anything about crypto until they get introduced to it and they learn about it. And Elon is that gatekeeper for millions of people. And when he went ahead and released this, this became massive news on tons of news outlets promoting the use of crypto to millions of people that might have not been exposed to it before. And because Doge is so mainstream, You have to understand that there are massive funds, and I'm not saying they're gonna invest in a meme coin. I'm saying there's massive funds that more than likely have some sort of stake in something like Doge. Now, why? It's because of the fact that if you're gonna sit here and tell me that something like a hedge fund or something like like an investment firm, whatever it is, will not invest in something that has an incredible market cap, has an incredible community, but let's just say they don't care about all that. The money that's flowing into Doge, the money that's flowing in and out of Doge every single day, if you try to sit here and tell me there's not some investment firms that are private that are not investing in Doge to go ahead and maybe they're scalping, maybe they're going ahead and holding for a few months, whatever it is. But if you're gonna sit here and tell me they don't, we would both be lying to each other, because there's definitely investment firms that do that, which again, prop up how much money is being allocated into Doge, thus increasing the market cap, and again, thus going ahead, raising the price of Doge and making it almost finding a kind of like a bottom, if you will. And I definitely think that the 20 to 30 cent range is the Doge bottom. And that's where we're gonna go ahead and see, support, very strong support. And then obviously the next bull run, I definitely think that Doge will be heading to a dollar, if not more, because more people are getting introduced to crypto, as I just explained before. So the more people that get introduced, they're getting introduced through coins like Doge, like Shiba Inu, etc. Now, giving more validity to Dogecoin and the community and the power of it being an actual transactional currency, there's companies that now allow Doge to be used as a transaction to receive X, Y, and Z good. So let's just take a look right over here. Everybody knows about the Mavericks, and they made a very important post over here. BitPay, the world's largest provider of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency payment services, today announces the rollout of Dogecoin payments for merchants and consumers. And so, long story short, Maverick fans for life can now use Dogecoin to buy tickets and merchandise online. And essentially, Mavs use BitPay, which could have used BTC, Bitcoin Cash, Ethereum, USDC, GUSD, PAX, BUSD, and now Doge. And because they introduced Doge, they have seen more transactions of Doge in a single day than they have in totality with Bitcoin. And like I said before, the reason for this is because Bitcoin is a store of value. You're gonna be holding your Bitcoin for long term, not necessarily using it as a transactional means. But there's other companies like right down here, Post Oak Motor Cars, Kessler Collection, Air Baltic, EasyDNS. There are companies that will be adopting this. And once a company, let's just say like PayPal, goes ahead and says, hey, we'll accept Doge as a form of payment, I don't see this being far off. And why don't I see this being far off? Is because of the fact that if there's enough people that use it, why would use it as a transactional means? Why would a company that's a payment processor not go ahead and offer something that will essentially provide more ways for people to pay, thus increasing how much revenue that particular company like PayPal makes? Because at the end of the day, what board members want to see and public companies want to see is more revenue and growth. And with the movement of cryptocurrency, you would be very foolish not to go ahead and offer cryptocurrency as payment to anybody who's trying to look to pay in Doge, essentially, or any crypto. So we've seen PayPal go ahead and start accepting certain cryptocurrencies, and I do believe with time, we will see them accept Doge as well. So keep that in mind. So right over here, you can see, just to tidy up this point, PayPal will let users pay with Bitcoin, Ethereum, and Litecoin, but we all know this already, but I do foresee them adding more, and Doge is not off the table. Lastly, what I'll say is the community for Doge is insane, not only on crypto Twitter, but you have to take a look at the community on Reddit. Check this out. There's over 2 million subscribers and over 10 or 9,000 viewing in the room right now, and it's currently Sunday at 12:37 a.m. in the morning. So yes, I'm recording this Saturday night into Sunday. But again, we can just see the interactions. Look at all these comments. Look at the upvotes. Look at the engagement. The community is so engaged. The community is absolutely incredible. And let's not even talk about crypto Twitter, where they're super engaged, shilling to everybody. So when we see crypto Twitter, it's like friends of friends pick it up, and then their friends will pick it up, and then those friends of their friends will pick it up. It just becomes one massive circle, and everybody starts hearing about Doge, and then people want to get involved because they see how many other individuals are making money. Then we see stories like that individual on YouTube, I completely forgot his name, where he became a Dogecoin millionaire. He put all his money in on the basis of the fact that Elon Musk kept tweeting about it and talking about it, so it has to go up. Now, that logic, pretty interesting. Did it work? Oh yeah, so it worked. Now, what I will say to end this off is you want to dollar cost average your way into Doge. And I do believe this is a great price to go ahead and get in at, because of the fact that, you know, Doge is definitely going to see an incredible growth spurt on its way up with Bitcoin on Bitcoin's next leg up. So from here on out, ride Doge to the bottom is what I'm going to be doing, not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor, but riding Doge down and then enjoying the fruits of dollar cost averaging on your way back up is something that you can expect if you decide to invest and put your money into Doge. Like I said, not financial advice. But if you want more videos like this and breaking down Doge and how it all works and more information about it, smack a like on this button, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you think about this video. My name is Dan from the Hidden Gem Network, and it has been a phenomenal pleasure to just talk to everybody who's involved with Doge and the Doge community. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much, and I can't wait to see you very soon. Have a great one.